The ministry of Elijah House Japan started with the vision and calling God gave John and Paula Sanford in the 1970s. As pioneers of Bible-based prayer ministry, John and Paula Sanford have written books that have touched thousands of lives all over the world. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And he will turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the hearts of the children to their fathers, lest I come and strike the earth with a curse. Elijah House Japan has now taken up the mantle, doing prayer ministry based on the Bible, the cross, and led by the Holy Spirit, holding seminars and schools in which lives are transformed. Many are learning to do the ministry, and churches are being blessed. The story of how Elijah House Japan began could not be told without first telling the story of Miss Evelyn Owen, a Southern Baptist missionary in Japan since 1956. While she was working with the Otsu Baptist Church in 1993, the church started cell groups where Evelyn began to realize that behind the beautiful faces, there were many hidden hurts and concerns. Evelyn began to cry out to God as to how to help these friends. Unknown to Evelyn, there were also others praying for Elijah House prayer ministry to be birthed in Japan. In the fall of 1996, Evelyn was in the Japan Baptist Hospital. While there, she listened to a set of tapes by John and Paula Sanford. The message went right to her spirit. And the Lord revealed areas where she needed to forgive and receive healing. She also learned about a three-week Elijah House School of Prayer Ministry. When she got out, she immediately wrote to Elijah House to inquire about the schools. Meanwhile, God had been working in the heart of a retired civil engineer and Navy man, Herb Eggar. He and Evelyn had been close friends when she was in high school and he was in college. However, Evelyn had refused marriage to Herb and went on to fulfill her call to be a missionary in Japan. Herb later married a woman named Martha, who after many years died of cancer in 1991. About this time, Herb's pastor started emphasizing missions and encouraged people to pray for their missionaries. Herb remembered his friend Evelyn that had gone on to Japan and sent her a card for Easter 1996. Busy as a missionary, Evelyn lost the card and never wrote back. But a year later, in 1997, Herb sent her his second annual Easter card and asked her what he could pray for. This time, Evelyn answered and asked him to pray that she would be accepted at the three-week Elijah House School of Prayer Ministry to be held in Washington State in June, and told him about the books she needed to read to prepare for the school. Herb immediately went to the local Baptist bookstore, found a copy of Restoring the Christian Family by the Sanfords, began reading it, and was greatly impacted. Evelyn was accepted into the Elijah House School in Washington, and one day, one of the lessons had been about making an inner vow, or firm decision to do or not to do something, especially because of some wounds or bitterness in the heart. For homework, the students were to pray and see if they had made an inner vow, and if so, to break it before the Lord. Evelyn thought that she had never made an inner vow, but when she prayed, God showed her that she had made a vow never to be married. She was shocked, but then prayed and asked the Lord to forgive her, and she broke the vow before the Lord. It was about an hour after this that the phone rang. And she heard Herb's voice for for the first time in almost 50 years. During the next months, God worked in a wonderful way in both Herb's and Evelyn's life, and the two were married March 7th, 1998, by Pastor Eiichi Hamasaki at Otsu Baptist Church. Later, they attended the three-week school together in June 1998 in the U.S. While they were there, God gave them the vision and desire to have the school materials put into Japanese to share with the people of Japan.
We thank you, dear Jesus, that you shed your blood.
With the blessing of Elijah House in America, Evelyn and Herb started the first Elijah House school in Japan as a small group of five in English at Otsu Baptist Church. Therefore, we pray that the Holy Spirit. Cyril and Masako Wankum were the first ones to complete the school in the fall of 1999. During this time, the Eggars, Wankums, and Pastor Hamasaki had been praying about how this teaching and ministry could be shared with more Japanese Christians. So in October 1999, Otsu Baptist Church sponsored a seminar on healing family relationships and a Keys of Transformation workshop with Elijah House counselors and teachers. In the spring of 2000, another video school in English was held at Otsu Baptist. Richard and Jan O'Brien came to teach and support while also doing short seminars in Otsu and Yokohama. By now, it was clear that one of John and Paula Sanford's books needed to be published in Japanese. Arrangements were made to have Transformation of the Inner Man translated. John and Paula Sanford were also invited to come to Japan to teach seminars in Otsu, Yokohama, and Sapporo in January 2001. At the John Sanford Otsu Seminar, the Eggars met a young housewife, Mrs. Takako Kobukata, who said she had been praying for this kind of ministry to come forth for many years. She said, "I will help you," and ever since has been an important co-worker and assistant, commuting between Kobe and the Elijah House office in Otsu to help forward the vision which God had put on her heart. It was with much rejoicing that the first Japanese language basic school of prayer ministry could finally be planned. Each of the places that had hosted a Sanford seminar now wanted to have a school. Workbooks were translated, and the first basic school week one course was planned for the fall of 2001 with teachers from Elijah House, USA. However, due to the terrorist attack in New York on September 11th, plans had to be postponed. Finally, in the spring of 2002, Elijah House sent a wonderful team to teach and support. Robert and Kathy Fettweit were former missionaries in Japan whom the Lord had been preparing for over 20 years in the prayer counseling ministry to become an integral part of the work of Elijah House in Japan. Elijah House schools in Japan, after much prayer and effort, had finally taken off. Basic School 1, Week 2, was held in the same three cities of Otsu, Yokohama, and Sapporo. And the 326 people that returned had much to share about how God had been working in their lives since the first school. During the schools, the Eggars were reminded of the word God gave Cyril Wancombe in the fall of 2001 that God's purpose for Elijah House ministry in Japan was to raise up shepherds who, because of the healing and transformation they were receiving, could more and more minister with a true shepherd's heart. Later that year, the door opened to expand the Elijah House ministry into Okinawa. It was clear that basic two schools needed to be taught live in a combined situation by teachers from Elijah House. The location selected was the Doshisha Retreat Center just north of Otsu by Lake Biwa. The Fetvites and Ericksons were teachers again, with 95 attending. Teaching and group ministry were deeper, and we saw more of God's purpose for Elijah House Ministry Schools. For here, students from all parts of Japan and from many different denominations and churches were under one roof, sharing the deepest things of their hearts, forming bonds with each other, and seeing God work to bring healing and change. God showed the Eggars that prayer ministry was in many ways like washing one another's feet or heart of the dirt, sins, and wounds accumulated in the hidden recesses of our hearts. God reminded them that Jesus challenged his closest 12 disciples to have a serving heart as he did. The Eggars asked, Lord, who are the disciples of Elijah House in Japan? And the Lord brought to mind 12 individuals who had given of themselves from the beginning to bring forth this ministry. They realized as they looked at a map of Japan that the 12 were from key cities from the north to the south and places in between. Through them and many others, God has been and will be calling. The 12 covenanted together to pray. After the week three schools in the spring of 2003, Robert and Kathy Fetvite also taught a series of seminars on the topic Blessed Family Relationships, John and Paula Sanford's second book, Restoring the Christian Family, was being published in Japanese. These seminars were also videotaped. In January 2004, at the invitation of a committee of church leaders in Hokkaido, a seminar on restoring the family was conducted by John and Paula Sanford's son, Mark, along with Robert and Kathy Fetvite. After the Sapporo seminar, Mark stayed in Japan to join the Fetvites in starting prayer ministry internships, a 24-week prayer ministry training program for those with a special call to this ministry. At last, the time arrived in March 2004 for the long-awaited last week of the school, Basic 2, Week 4. About 85 of those who were qualified to attend gathered again at Doshisha Retreat Center for a rich, even more in-depth week of teaching. One of the goals from the beginning was that those who have already completed the school be able to take this blessing to their own churches by facilitating a school. One pastor said that Elijah House Ministry is now a key for my church. About 20 facilitators are now hosting video schools in their churches throughout Japan. Pastor Roichi Masuda of Ateine Christ Church in North Japan shares how he integrated the Elijah House ministry into his church. In 1990, the Lord gave me the scripture in Psalms 126, verse 4, "Bring back our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south." And I sensed that the Lord was saying that there was a time coming when the captives in Japan would be set free. In 1996, we became a cell church and had a goal to reach at least one person in 100 within the suburb of Teine. However, we faced many difficulties in relationships between cell members, and we realized that these problems were related to issues of the heart, and that this was preventing the furtherance of the gospel. We prayed earnestly about this matter. And then, in 1999, I attended, along with three of my staff members, the first Elijah House seminar at the Otsu Baptist Church. As a result, we produced a pamphlet for our cell groups called The Keys to Change. In 2001, I was invited to be part of the planning committee for John Sanford Seminars in North Japan. One of the blessings we received was the confidence that this Elijah House ministry in God's timing was the means to prepare the church to see revival come to Japan. The second blessing was that the cell groups were greatly encouraged. John Sanford, in his book, Transformation of the Inner Man, relates how this ministry evangelizes the unbelieving parts of the believer's heart. The third blessing was to see Elijah House teachers teach as husband-wife teams, and I was challenged to do the same. After prayer, my wife and I started to do monthly teaching sessions using Elijah House material. From 2002, Elijah House schools have been conducted in our city, and many of our church members participated. And we have just completed our second round of schools. Many of our leaders and cell group supervisors have completed the Elijah House basic school training. This became a perfect discipleship training school, and prayer ministry is done within the cell groups. Lives and relationships are being transformed. The next thing that God prepared us for was ministry to the unsaved. We started a free counseling facility open to the general public. Friends and relatives of church members have been ministered to, healed, and saved. We sense that God's time for Japan is very near. It was clear that this was a ministry that God was raising up to bless the churches and through them many in the nation of Japan. Much prayer had been going up to know God's plan. The Eggers had received a letter from Elijah House giving the blessing to call the ministry Elijah House Japan, with the understanding that they would work toward meeting the requirements for using this name. God had already been calling out many to serve in and through Elijah House. The group of 12 prayed together. Of these 12, 4 were chosen and committed to plan and pray toward forming a board of directors. Now the committed group of 4 pastors have decided to name themselves Active Servant Team. All along, there has been faithful staff serving in answer to God's call to serve the Lord through Elijah House Japan. Yumiko and Masanori Miura have been involved in Elijah House ministry since they were students in that first English school in the spring of 2000. Working with the Hokkaido Elijah House Committee, Masanori has facilitated Sapporo's large video schools of more than 100 students each. Masanori and his wife Yumiko have become the first to complete the Elijah House internship program. They are answering God's call to serve Elijah House more in the future. Masanori to serve as director intern, to become director in God's timing. Elijah House Japan has been raised up to serve individuals, families, churches, and the many in Japan who still need a real, loving, healing, and transforming touch from the Lord Jesus Christ.